Number 3, Data Handling. In this chapter, we will have questions which would have certain data. And from that data, we have to find mean, we have to find highest and lowest numbers, we have to find range and so on. So let us start with exercise 3.1. Question number 1. Find the range of heights of any 10 students of your class. We have to find out the range of student, range of height of students of your class. So we are assuming heights as 117, 111, 114 and so on. See, when we have to find range, we have to subtract middle of highest number and lowest number. So in this you can see that highest number is 120. Whereas lowest number, it means minimum height is 110. So if I subtract that numbers, I will get range. So answer will be 120 minus 110, which will give 10 as answer. Question number 2. Organize the following in class assessment in table form. See, we have certain marks of class assessment. In table form, it means we have to arrange that marks in table. Next, we have certain questions. Which number is highest? Which number is lowest? What is the range? And find arithmetic mean. First of all, we will write this number in tabular form via tally marks. Let us start. See, here we have one number which is coming only one time. So we will put 1 tally mark for 1. Next is 2 number. So 2 number is coming twice, 1 and 2. So we will put 2 tally marks for 2. See, I have written marks, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 9. Because lowest mark over here is 1 and highest mark over here is 9. Okay? So tally marks. I told you how to write tally marks. Tally marks we have done. Then number of students, it means how many students got 1 mark. So answer will be 1. How many students got 2 marks? Answer will be 2, because we have 2 tally marks. Next one, how many students got 3 tally marks? Answer will be 1. For 4, it will be 3. For 5, it will be 5. See, whenever we have tally marks more than 4, we will put a cross mark, because it will be easier for us to calculate such marks in future. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So answer will be 5. Next is for 7, 4, 8, 2 and 1, 9, 1. Now we have to multiply column 2 and column 3, because that will lead in future. So 1 1 gives 1. 2 2's are is 4. 1 1's are is 1. 3 3's are 9 and so on. Now we have to add number of students and last column. If we add number of students, we will get answer 25. And for column 2 and 3, we will get 100. It means total marks will be 100. Now let us answer the questions. Which number is highest? As we know, number written at the last will be highest. So the number is 9. Next is which number is lowest. So number written at the top is lowest. Answer will be 1. What is the range? As we have done in question number 1, range means highest number minus lowest number. So 9 minus 1 is equal to 8. by 3 is equal to 10.67. But highest mean is of 12.5. So A is the best.